Andrew here, my boy Andre. He's gonna teach me how to play guitar, and this kind of guitar, because I kind of know how to play this one. The one he has, I don't know how to play at all.
Well, it's the same. It's okay.
Same bit, yeah.
While we're playing, let me explain some things. So, this electric guitar you have, it applies to the same rules as any other guitar. The only thing special about it is that it's electric, so you can change the kind of sounds that come out of it.
Yeah.
Electric guitars are kind of really, like, they're really cool. You can do a lot more stuff with electric guitars than you can with acoustics. Same thing goes for the type of strings that they have. But electric guitars have a different sound, not just because it has an output. Plus, they're a lot heavier. Now, let's start with G. G is a pretty easy chord to play.
First key, second.
So, your pointer finger, are you left-handed or right-handed?
I'm actually left-handed, but
if you're right-handed, then hold finger with your left.
This feels more comfortable.
Yeah, it feels more comfortable. So, with your pointer finger, you want to put it on the second string, on the second fret, like this. With your middle finger, you want to put it on the first string, third fret. So low note, and you want to put your pinky or your ring finger on the last string, third fret. It's gonna be this last string on the same fret this is. Because this is low E, this is high E. So, can you see this again? You wanna switch it to your pinky. Make sure you move this finger out so it's more comfortable. Okay, go ahead and switch it back. It's probably easier for you to do that instead of...
Yeah, that's easier. It feels way easier.
And now, here's an very, very easy chord to play. It's called E minor. You want to just use two fingers. Doesn't matter which one. It depends on the transition. So, for this transition, I'm going to have you use your middle finger and your ring finger and put it on the same finger your pointer finger was on, same string your pointer finger was on, so it's gonna be here. So move that there. And, you know, you don't need that, but what else? You can move your ring finger right behind it, right next to it. It's gonna be on the third string, second fret. So your ring finger goes in the your ring finger goes in the second fret, third string. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So third string?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And second fret.
Second, okay, so let's put it
there. Now, with your pointer finger, you don't really need that there, it depends on the transition. But this pointer finger, you don't really need it there right now. You need to put your ring finger, your middle finger, on the string above that, in the same fret. Should be like that, right? Go ahead and strum down. This is called E minor. Now, there's another chord. If you want to play E, normal E, put your pointer finger on the fourth string on the first fret.
Wait.
So it's going to be right here. Don't take anything off. It's going to be there. Just strum. Take it off. Going to put it on the...
Oh, you need the...
capo?
Yeah.
So make sure when you do it, you know how you play... If you ever play piano, a good thing to do is to have a bridge, which means there should be space underneath your hands. That's what you want to have when you're playing guitar so that you don't hit any other strings.
Mm-hmm.
So, this E minor, this is E. So, taking away that one finger, it's E minor, adding it, it's E. Now, the next chord I want you to play is a C. So, So what you want to do is you want to put your pointer finger on the fifth string. You want to put your pointer finger on the fifth string. Fifth string, first fret. Pointer finger.
What finger?
On the fifth string. One, two, three, four, five. Fifth string.
I feel like I'm being taught like first grade over again. Mm-hmm. The first.
Mm-hmm. Move this on the third string. Move that pointer finger on the first string. I know, it's very there. What you could do, you can lean it over and try fingering it like that. Just stroke. Should we see? You're hitting that last string right there. I want to use this one. Okay, so when strumming with this, you actually don't use, you don't hit this. You're just supposed to use five strings, but I hit the entire thing. So now you're supposed to play. So yeah, that's C. That's perfect C. Now let's play D. Now let's play D. This is kind of weird, but it's not that hard. So you want to put your middle finger on the last string, second fret. Then you want to put your pointer finger on the fourth string, second fret. Now, you want to put your ring finger on the 5th string, 3rd fret.
Wait, so 1st finger goes
here.
1, 3.
So it should go here. And the next one here. Now, you want to move every single one of those pieces up by one. Let's go you're too low. And I like to strum the entire board, and since E, low E and high E are the same thing, I put my thumb here if you can reach. So strum four chords. One, two, three, four. Just the last one, so should we?
That's three.
What you could do is
there and there. I got it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Hold, grab this. So this is what I've been trying to show you how to play. B. One, two, three. That's what it should all sound like. So.
It is quite heavy.
It is, yeah. It's not too hard to learn, but it is a pain in the butt to do over and over again. So that is somewhere else. You want to be higher.
Higher, okay.
Yeah. Most of these strings are going to be played up here, which is...
So I only play four strings at a time?
It depends. So let's go back to G. Let's go all the way back to G. So look at me. Well, look at me once, and I want to see if you can do it. So put my pointer finger in. One or two. That's G. Go ahead and see if you can do the same.
Okay, so wait, do it. Wait, what finger?
Okay. Look at me from behind, because it's kind of weird, yeah. One, two, three, one. No, switch it.
Okay.
Up. Switch these two. Yep. Now, move your fingers a little more lower around the end. Make sure that's still in the same key. And then you have the finger back there. Yep. So it depends which one, but for G and E minor, they're gonna cover the entire board. For C and D, I don't think so.
Okay, so those notes.
play G, now you want to go to E minor, which is just the two fingers. You can use your pointer finger and your middle finger. Just go ahead and use those two. Strum the entire board. That's E minor. Now, whatever you do, don't move your middle finger. Move your pointer finger up here to the fifth string. Move your, fifth string. Now move your ring finger right below that. No, that's your middle finger. Move your ring finger right below that. Yep.
Below?
Not directly below, but like on the string next to it. Yeah, there.
All of it.
Mm-hmm. So when you play this chord, you're not supposed to hit this string. But again, like I said, I do the same. There are different techniques and different styles on how you play. I just do it incorrectly, kind of like when I speak Spanish.
Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed me failing. And this is Andre, buddy here. Go subscribe to him right here. And hope you guys like this video. Like, subscribe, and peace.